Hi everyone, I'm G1 Writer with G1 Insights, and let me tell you, the month of April is a tricky one, okay? Because we're still going to be dealing with that Aries and full moon, I mean the Aries new moon, happening on March 24th. So the first week of April, like any first beginning of the month, is going to be a bit, you know, we got to ease our way in, okay? But then as we get closer to like the end of the first week, that is when our energy can kind of pick up and be just a bit different. Now, in February and March, of course, we had like some disruptions, of course, because of Mercury retrograde. And then we had like the coronavirus breakout. So it's extremely important, guys, that in the month of April that we are listening to each other, especially that first 2 or 3 weeks. We need to listen to one another. We need to follow directions. We need to be, you know, we need to pay attention to our communication. Let's not be objective. Let's not be stubborn. Let's take things one step at a time. Let's not rush into things. So let's not be impulsive, okay? Now, especially until by the end of April, things should clear the way. But I feel like communication should get better by the end of March, going into the beginning of April. But still, the energy for everyone is different because everyone's situation is different. Everyone is going through different things. Some people are homeless, some people are hungry, some people are fighting for their lives out here. So this, you know, it's really important that we communicate to our best ability. It's really important that we are listening very closely to one another and that we are attentive to ourselves as we are to other people, okay? It is also important that we are not as stubborn. Now, because I'm saying all this energy, because April 7th or 8th, give or take a day, we have a full moon in Libra. And the full moon in Libra, you know, normally Libra is all about support and love and giving and sharing and caring and being, you know, full of justice and standing up for all that's right, you know. But with it being a full moon in Libra, this is, I'm still going to stand for what I want, but I'm being stubborn about it. You can't move me. You know, you can't tell me what to do. You can't tell me how to act. You can't to know what to say. You know, the full moon in Libra is also can kind of bring some mal disruptions amongst like friends or like if this is why I say communication is going to be so important, especially even towards family, people that you love, people that you haven't seen in a while. They may not feel like they need to listen to you. But it's really important that everyone pays attention to this type of energy, okay? As I begin to do your cards, I want you guys to really pay attention to the things that I'm saying to you, to the energy waves that are flowing through. Now, we do have a new moon in Taurus, and that is going to happen towards the end of the month. That's going to happen around the 22nd of April. Now, that may give us a chance to be a bit more logical and practical about our affairs or things that we need done, okay? But the first week of April is expected to be a bit challenging, especially with everything that's going on in the world. Everyone is not going to be on board. Everyone may be moody or have attitudes. This can be situations at work, people storming out on you, people closing the door on your face, people cursing you out, saying F you, you know. Try not to get too emotional. The full moon in Libra is, you know, a very sociable time. So you want to communicate. You want to be out there. However, it's also a very emotional time. And with everything happening around the world, we want to make sure that we are on point, that we're paying attention, that we are being sensitive to other people's needs, and that we're not being objective. Okay, you want to listen with your whole heart. And we want to be careful that we're not allowing our ego to take over, okay? Make sure that you guys are really, really listening to spirit and what spirit is sharing with you. For those of you that are having like lucid like type dreams, pay attention to your dreams. If you are constantly having dreams of families or of your family, of your friends, or if maybe if you've been having dreams of your workplace for some reason, if it's a really strong, tense energy, I want you guys to really, really pay attention to what spirit is sharing with you. And don't panic, you know, but really, really write down everything you see. Write down everything you hear, because it will make total sense when everything begins to play out. It's going to make a whole lot more sense, okay? So, guys, I'm sharing this with you, and I really hope that your reading is going to enlighten you and uplift you, because I know that for earth signs, especially in fire signs, it's going to be a tremendous, beautiful year. But for water signs and air signs, it's going to be a bit tricky. Okay? So you guys want to take these past next few weeks, like one step at a time, okay? Don't force a situation to happen. Just allow it to naturally begin for you. Allow it to naturally happen. Don't try to force something to happen for you, okay? So guys, I love you. And without further ado, here is your life and love energy for the month of April. Bye, guys. Hi everybody, I'm G1 Writer with G1 Insights, and today I am providing you with your life and love energy for the month of April 2020. This is for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, and Rising, or Venus and Capricorn. Capricorn, I'm really amazed at how far you've grown, how far you've come, and how much you've grown, okay? It seems like a lot of you are dealing with some immediate fears, dealing with, you know, your well-being and being concerned about your, you know, like if you guys are employed or maybe you guys are searching for a job. A lot of you guys have been really, really worried a lot about your stability, about your finances. But I can tell you, Capricorn, you have nothing to worry about, okay? There may be a temporary standstill, you know, but you're not the only one dealing with this phase. You know, there's a lot of us in the world that are stressed out, you know, concerned, worried about the economy. You know, there's so many of us that are feeling like, well, what if, you know? And so I do, you know, with the Eight of Swords here, of course, there's like this lack of confidence, you know, being afraid, not sure of what's going to happen, you know, a lack of self-confidence, even being afraid to kind of step forward. But I will also tell you, though, Capricorn, is that even though you may have these fears early on, I feel like it's only because things are moving so fast. It's like it's moving along at a pace that you're not really used to. And even though you are very, very ambitious by nature, you know, you do like to move at your own pace. And so a lot of times when things are seem like you're being forced to do something or you have to hurry up and do something or when things are feeling like it's being rushed or and things feel like it's falling apart, it's not falling apart, Capricorn. What is happening is there's a shift that is taking place and Spirit, God, the universe is literally preparing you for your greater good, okay? You are being prepared for the greater good. When I was shuffling your cards, I just kept hearing overflow of abundance. An overflow of abundance, okay? So there's not, you know, I don't think that there's like, I don't think this fear is going to last forever. I do believe that it's temporary. Again, with the awakening card being here, this is a spiritual element, guys. Archangel Gabrielle, you know, this is a spiritual card. And, you know, it's like you're being called to action. You're being called to do something. You know, so you, a lot of you guys may feel like you need to defend yourself in a very pleasant way. Normally you can, you know, be quick to snap or put somebody in their place. But this season, I feel like you guys are doing it gracefully. Like you're telling someone about themselves or you're standing up for yourself in a way where people don't have no choice really but to show you that immediate respect, okay? And I don't feel like you're going to play too much into the nonsense. Like, things that are going on around you, you're like, look, if it's not about my money, my family, my children, you know, I don't really give a damn. Like, I just feel like you guys are taking this whole approach, like, this whole seriousness that everybody say that Capricorns have. You're not really being that serious about it at all. You're like, you know, whatever. It is what it is. You're basically letting the bad times or the negativity roll off your shoulder. Because obviously you know better than anybody, Capricorn, that we cannot manifest anything if we are worried or if we are panicking or if we're stressed out. We can't bring goodness into our worlds if we're constantly stressing over it. So you are choosing, and this is why I said inflow or overflow of some type of abundance, because you are putting yourself in a position where you're not allowing, you know, negativity to get to you. You're not allowing what people have to say to get to you. You're not sitting back allowing people to hurt you. Like, you're literally just going to be like, you know what? It is what it is. Like, we can't always control everything, right? Fuck it. You know, I got to pay this bill. It is what it is. Okay? I can't get that job. It is what it is. There's always another job out there. My boss getting on my nerve. It is what it is. Maybe they're cranky. Maybe they're having a bad day. Like, you're not allowing the little things to get to you. And this puts you in a position to really, truly manifest. And I always tell you, Capricorn, what is the one thing I always tell you? You are the master of manifestation. So, Capricorn, we need you in this world to do what you always do, to show us how you do what you do and how you stay grounded in the most trying times, in the times where everything is falling apart. You tend to just march ahead and you're not worried. You're like, hello, everybody. Hi. You know, you're going about your business and everybody's like, well, what the hell is wrong with them? How come they can be so grounded and stable-minded and not frustrated and going crazy over this? Because you've learned the hard way. Even as a child, you've learned the hard way. You know what it's like not to have. You know what it's like to be an adult from early on. You know what it's like. You know what responsibility calls for. And so even though you're not really totally mentally ready to just take action, Spirit is urging you to take action. So just, you're being called to just do something, okay? And so what that means is not sitting around having a pity party, but in fact, you're going to do the complete opposite. I'm not going to sit around and continue feeling sorry for myself. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just apply for this other job because apparently this is not working for me. So I need to make some changes, okay? I'm not going to sit around and keep being bullied by this person. I don't like the situation I'm in. I don't like this house. You know, I don't like this car. This is not working. Me and my family need more. We need a van instead of a little hoopty. Like, you guys are making little small changes. And what it's doing is it's helping you to create like that foundation that you want, Capricorn. So this is really good. You know, again, you're looking at things from a different perspective. So this is really, really good, Capricorn. Okay. Next, I do see the Ace of Air. Okay. The Ace of Swords. So you got the Eight of Swords here in traditional tarot deck. That is the Eight of Swords. Okay. And in traditional tarot deck, this is the Ace of Swords. Okay. So what that means is being honest, being, you know, straightforward in your thought process. And like I said, these people, whoever this, whatever environment you're in or whatever situation you're going to be dealing with, you're dealing with it in a way where you're being honest, you're being assertive, but you're doing it gracefully. You are stating what you want, why you want it, and when you need it by. Like, you are being very precise with your point of action. You're being precise with what you need and what needs to be done. You are like nothing to fuck with this season. Like, you are going in and you're dominating things in a way, but you're not going in as a bully or being harsh. You're going in as a way where people, even higher ups, will have no choice but to respect you and honor you and like you because you're taking your place back in the world, Capricorn, and you're doing it gracefully, okay? So brilliant new ideas. Whatever type of ideas are coming to you, Capricorn, again, I keep hearing the overflow of abundance. So the littlest ideas, the things that seem impossible, you know, seem far-fetched, the ones that seem a bit crazy or strange. You know, if you have a dream about something that you saw yourself doing and you wake up and you're like, why would I dream of something like that? Write it down. You know, don't take those moments for granted because Spirit is obviously sharing with you something that you need to know. Okay, but you're also going to be seeing the truth of a situation. So again, there's that moment this season where you're going to have to face reality for what it is. Okay, there might be some people, like picking with you in a sense. But again, you're not going to put any attention to that. Okay, this is a season for you, Capricorn, to have fun where you're literally allowing things to roll off your back and you're like, you're laughing at it and you're going, I'm not tripping over this. Like, and you're going to go home and laugh about it and shake your shoulders to it. So while everybody's going crazy and losing their mind, you're like in La La Land having the best time of your life. And, you know, people are going to be like, okay, something is seriously wrong. Like, people are going to think you're crazy, Capricorn, because you are in no position. Like, I feel like as if you just don't want to waste time crying over spilled milk. Like, you don't want to waste any time, you know, investing your energy into something that can't really get you anywhere. So if you are still being quarantined, you know, with everything that's going on in the world today, you know, of course there are fears, of course there are concerns, but should we actually stop our life? Should we stop living? Should we stop being funny and optimistic because all these things are going on? No. for those of you that have children, you know, be your best self. Show your children just how exciting and fun you can really be. That you're not just this stick in the mud, you know, that you're not, or this strict, serious parent all the time, you know. This is going to be the season where you are basically being given a free chance to just be yourself, to just laugh at the little things, to spend more time with your family. You know, it's kind of like a blessing in disguise. So yes, it's a very painful and emotional time for most families and people in the world. But thankfully, Capricorn, you're using this energy to say, well, you know what? I've been waiting to spend more time with my family anyway. You know, or, well, I've been meaning to start that paint job, or I've been meaning to clean my shoes. I've been meaning to clean out my closet. Like, you're using this time in a very, very positive way. And we need that type of energy, Capricorn. You have four planets in your sign at the moment, okay? So you have four planets in your sign. That means that you are dealing with an energy so tense and powerful, and Pluto being one of those planets, you know, of course, there's a lot of tense energy. So let me move forward, okay, guys? You also have the Empress, okay? If I'm not mistaken, I do believe either Leo or Sagittarius got this energy, guys. So lavish abundance, giving birth to your dreams, okay? Nurturing yourself and other people. This is definitely a time, again, where you want to just kind of take a step back and focus on your creativity, focus on things that you love. You know, if you notice you have this passion for something, you haven't been able to do it, use this time wisely. Use this time. There's that number 1111 again. I keep seeing it. So use this time wisely. And look at this, guys, 12 and 21. To really, really, really do the things that you love to do, okay? Look at 1122. This is crazy, guys. I just keep seeing that number, Capricorn. 1111, 1221. You know, 1122, like, oh my God, new beginnings, growth, okay, guys? So let's look here and let's see if we can get some wisdom for you guys. I kind of already pre-shuffled this deck. So please share with me some cards for our beautiful Capricorns for the month of April 2020. What can Capricorn expect? Any type of knowledge or information you want to share with Capricorn, please share with us now. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Wow, self-resilience, self-reliance, okay? Don't be afraid to fly solo. Like I said, there's going to be some people that's on board with you. There's going to be some people that try to come against you, Capricorn. But as you see, this person is like, look, I ain't got time for your BS, okay? Like, I'm so ready to just, like, if you ain't on this train, then this train about to depart in about 5 minutes. And if you ain't on this train, then I'll meet you in the next lifetime. Like, you are not wasting any time crying over spilled milk. You are not. You are so determined to move forward and to be successful that you're literally not allowing anything to get you off track. So this is really, really beautiful, Capricorn. Self-reliance. Very beautiful. Please show me another one for our beautiful Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Horizon, or Venus in Capricorn. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, Capricorn, let's see what else the universe has for you. Now, guys, I also see here the World card as well. So, of course, that is definitely about resources, being resourceful, tapping into your resourceful energy. Now, Capricorns, from what everybody mostly knows, is that you are usually the most resourceful. Like, when people need advice, they call you. When people need advice about money, they call you because they know that you're really good with finances, right? Usually, anyway, right? Unless you're not really that evolved, and of course, you may be struggling a bit on a financial tip. However, anyway, most Capricorns are really, really good with their finances, you know, stability, and so forth. And so a lot of people look up to you for those things, Capricorn. So you will be receiving a lot of rewards and recognition for all of your hard work for, again, there's that self-reliance here. You know, she's wearing a crown. She's sophisticated, you know. So you're being recognized for that, Capricorn. As you begin to nurture yourself and other people, people are going to gravitate to you more and more and more because they realize, okay, if she can do it, I can do it, okay? So a job well done. There's a lot of joy here, a lot of contentment, a lot of gratitude. Again, just really just being thankful in the moment. While everybody is going crazy, you're being focused on the positive. And so this is a really good energy, guys. I also see here the Nine of Pentacles, okay? The Nine of Pentacles, we already know, is about finances, fertility, Okay, this can also, sorry guys, I've got one hand I'm working with, okay? Successful self-employment, again, those things that you are passionate about, your creativity, those things that you have not worked on in a long time. This is the perfect time for you, Capricorn, to invest, to be invested in your home, to be invested in yourself, to be invested in your passion, in your creativity. If you always wanted to start your own business, this is the perfect time to really, really, you know, get going. Now, as I said before, there will be a challenging beginning, but it's not something that you can't overcome, okay? This is definitely something you'll be able to navigate through. It's not something that's going to hold you back. Thankfully, you guys are doing just fine, okay? So let's get that other wisdom card out, guys. Let's see what our spirit has for you. Sorry, guys. I just wanted to point that out to you really quickly. This is so scary. Guys, this is crazy. When I saw this card, I saw the word resilience. I swear to God. And then I was like, oh, that's not resilience. That's reliance. Right? And oh my God, what the hell? When I say spirit is working out in your favor, like working everything out in your favor, my love, I'm talking about improvements with yourself, improvements in the world, improvements in your home, especially when it comes to love, guys. If you notice that you haven't really been able to spend a lot of time with your spouse, this can be one of those moments where you say, come on, babe, let's go out, you know, come on, honey, like, let's create like a little picnic, or let's go to the park and just relax and enjoy our family day, you know, this is going to be that moment, Capricorn. Yeah, it's resilience, rise above tribulations. What did I tell you? There will be some type of moment of truth here where you will realize, you know what? I've realized I've been putting all my energy into this other person or this other situation that I don't think I've really sat back and really thought about, you know, what I'm missing. What am I missing here, you know? And so, yes, my love. So, especially if this is a love situation for a lot of you, please pay attention to your home environment, okay? Redecorate if you want to. Renovate if you want to. You know, just do something amazing that's going to make you and your family feel wonderful and feel stable and secure. Make sure that you are working on your marriage, that you're working on yourself so that way your marriage can improve. You know, this is a wonderful time, Capricorn, to kind of reinvent yourself, you know? So this is beautiful, guys. Oh my God, it's so crazy how I mentioned this word and it came right out. That is so crazy. And guys, you saw my hands over here, so it's not like I was like plucking through the deck and, you know, trying to find stuff, okay? Woo, Capricorn, that is some beautiful stuff there. Oh my God. So guys, let's see what spirit wants your soul to get attached to. Okay, what's going on? What is your soul yearning for? What is your soul speaking of? Please share with us Capricorn's overall soul's energy for the month of April 2020. Guys, I already pre-shuffled, so just give me 1 second. All right, show me Capricorn. Self-esteem. What did I say? Oh, my God. Look, guys. Oh, my God. Look. Oh, my God. It's like all your cards are in sync this season. Look at this. The Eight of Swords here. An illusion of being trapped. You guys are not trapped. A lack of self-confidence. You will be working on that. Again, it's important to be yourself, Capricorn. You are coming into that truth, seeing the truth of a situation. You will be realizing what went wrong, what you need to focus on, but you will not stay stuck on what went wrong. And that's going to be the beauty of it all, okay? So, wow, looking at things from a different perspective. Don't be afraid to take action. Like I said, you are being called to take action. My love, okay? I possess gifts of the soul that benefit me and other people. Again, you are the master of manifestation. You know how to create a wonderful lifestyle for you and those that you love. You know how to create stability. You know how to make the best of every situation. So, this is not the time to get, you know, being fair. This is a time to show people how to rise above those tribulations. This is a time to say, you know what? I'm done crying over this. I'm not going to worry about it because you know what? I know that God loves me. He's not going to leave me stuck in a situation I can't get out of. So, hello, wake up. Like, yeah, where's my confidence? I need to raise my vibration. I am going to work on my self-esteem because you know what? I'm done being bullied by people who think that they can just walk all over me. You know, especially whoever this energy is, like, it's like this aggressive energy is like trying to come at you this season. But like I said, I feel like, wow, love just popped out, guys. When I say, okay, love is key this season, love is key, okay? I'm telling you, those of you that have love on the brain, those of you that love your family and your friends, this is a time to really, really work on close relationships, guys, okay? Love. I commit to the practice of seeing the good in all things. Again, I am looking at things from a different perspective, okay? I am going to look at the truth in this situation. I'm going to enjoy life's little luxuries. I'm going to spend some quiet time alone. I'm going to focus on my creativity and my self-employment and my entrepreneurship. I'm going to focus on my goals, and I'm going to do anything that I can to make sure that me and my family is great and that we are well provided for, because God has given me the resources, okay? God has given you the resources, because we all know that Capricorn can be very resourceful, okay? Don't be afraid to fly solo. You may have to put somebody in their place. You may have to say, you know what? It's cool. I'll do it by myself. I've never been afraid. I've never ran from a challenge, and I ain't gonna stop today. Okay, so Capricorn, this is the energy where, again, you get to show us how you do that thing, okay? You get to show and prove and show the world why you are called Capricorn. You get to show the world who you are and where you come from. I hear a lot of you sharing your testimony. This is going to be a beautiful season, Capricorn. I don't know, you know, but I do feel like a lot of you are going to be sharing your testimony this season. You have so much to be thankful for. You are so humble this season, and it's like, again, you're just letting things roll off your back. You're like, okay, you know, you're gonna still be respectful. Look at this, again, on the path toward enlightenment. So you're definitely seeing things from a different perspective. You're not no longer giving in to your fears or the ideas of you that other people create. You're not doing that anymore. Please show me one more for our beautiful Capricorns. Wow, this is beautiful, Capricorn. Beautiful. Surrender. Wow, you guys are the first to get these cards right here, dude. And I want to point this out too, guys. I see a lot of purple here, okay? But surrender. I can release my need to control. Absolutely, because guess what? We can't control every little thing, okay? Guys, for those of you that have had questions, you know, and concerns, let's see what Spirit says for you when it comes to that. There's something better for you, Capricorn. So don't, no stressing. No stressing, guys. Yes, it is time, Capricorn. Go for whatever it is that you desire, my love. Capricorn, I love you. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. And you have an amazing week wherever you are, or amazing month, or wherever you are in this beautiful universe. And I love you. Thank you for watching, guys. Mwah.